Thabani Nkomonye's inquest continued. Hence, on Monday, it was a doctor that conducted post-mortem for the police. Today, the ad witness was present, who is a police officer, Bongozi Kunene, who works at Matapa Police Station at the Traffic Department. Kunene stated that he went with other two police officers who are Officer Tusi and Officer Msibi, and they were working night shift. He mentioned that they were armed with guns that had 10 bullets. He mentioned that they patrolled Kahlobile Road up until they reached the MR9 road heading for Nhlangano. Kunene said when near the road, they saw cars on the left side of the road. He said the cars were facing all directions. Kunene said they then went to the parked cars only to notice that no one was inside the cars. Kunene also mentioned that they then saw torch lights from the left side. They then went in the bush and they were assisted by a man that introduced himself as Makanya, then asked him what was going on. And Makanya mentioned it was an accident and showed them a car and a black Mazda registered VSD584AS that was by a tree facing the main road. Makanya was asked why the accident was not reported to the police, and he mentioned that they had tried several times but failed, hence he could not go through. Kunene said they then went to join the others that were in the bush searching for the driver or those that were in the car said to be involved in an accident. Kunene said the search took about 2 to 3 hours. Kunene says he kept asking those present, who were about 10 people doing the searching, as to why they would not see the driver. When they saw the accident, but he could not be answered. He said the people then started leaving the scene area one by one, and the last person to leave before the police was Makanya, who then asked for his contact details. They then asked Mangoba from the police to help take the car so it can be kept safe while the investigations continued. He stated that they then decided to go back to the bush and checked about 5 to 7 meters from where the car was, but couldn't find anyone. Kunene mentioned that they then called their manager, Zaichen Sithole, to explain to him about the accident. In the morning, they then went to Manzini Nazarene to check on those that were involved in another accident at Matapa, and they also asked if there is anyone that was brought to the hospital from Hlambeni, and they were told no. Kunene said he then went to check on the car that was found in Hlambeni, and he found it nicely parked in a safe place at the Matapa police station. He mentioned they were still worried about the people that were in the car. He stated that it was in their wish to go back to the accident scene during the day. They then knocked off at 8:30 in the morning, and they were expected to go back to work on Wednesday at 2 p.m. And that was the case. Kunene says when they got to work, they asked for feedback concerning the Hlambeni accident, and they were told by Zaichen Sithole that they still were not found. Kunene also stated that on Thursday morning, they received a call from Sibi letting him, know that he had got a call from Zaichen Mnisi from Zaichen Horton, who said he was doing an investigation about a certain car whereby relatives cannot find the driver. They then decided to go back to the accident scene, but his colleagues, who are Constable Tusi and Msibi, were then assigned other duties. He was told to go alone. He then went with Zaichen Dube and Zaichen Mota. He mentioned that from the Manzini crew, there was Zaichen Horton and Inspector Mgomedulu and other police from the correctional services. He said while he briefed them about the accidents, they saw a person from the bush raising a hand, showing them something in the bush. That is when they all went to him. That's when they all realized it was Thabani's body. He said the investigations were then continued by Inspector Mgomedulu. Kunene mentioned inside the car there was a black bag. Inside the bag was a diary that had caught appearances state. There were black shoes and a yellow cell phone they were given by Mr. Makanya they found at the accident scene. Empty alcohol bottles were also found and were kept safe. He mentioned that the car was severely damaged and had no tire at the front left side. The body was certified dead and taken to the mortuary. Kunene said in his experience working as a traffic officer, he thinks that the cause of the death might be that the driver was sleeping while driving or he was driving on a high speed. Advocate Tsotsi Mabila accused the police officer of lying and being selective in order to try shift the blame from the police force. Reporting for Maswati Channel, I am Nonhlanhla Thwala at Mathapa Correctional Services.